Well, the COVID class of 2021 has received their ATAR results after another tumultuous year in and out of the classroom. For many students, it was a nervous wait, and now it's time to plan the next steps.
After an anxious night's sleep, elation at a near-perfect ATAR. No! A result that doesn't seem quite real just yet.
It feels like a fever dream. You know, I don't really believe I've gotten this score or finished year 12 for that fact.
Year 12s in Victoria have had the odds stacked against them for not one but 2 years, learning from home intermittently during lockdowns. But for Richard Ha, the challenges of the pandemic have been more personal than most.
This year has been pretty rough because earlier in the year, my father did pass away from COVID, so it did make year 12 a lot more difficult.
And his dad would be proud. Richard now ducks of his year and applying to study at MIT in the United States.
I think the one thing he would want me to do is to make decisions that I won't regret in the future.
He's one of many to have risen to the challenge. Rui scored 99.85. She's hoping to study medicine.
It was a lot higher than what I was expecting, so it was a really good surprise for me.
39 Victorians achieved the top ranking of 99.95, 28 of them boys and 11 girls. More than 50,000 students received an ATAR with an average ranking of 69.26, girls scoring higher than boys overall. But that number isn't the end of the story.
Your study scores, your ATARs, do not define you. There are many, many paths to success.
While some students are excitedly rushing to take the next step in their lives, others are taking some time to stop and smell the roses.
Hopefully volunteer at some places, try things I've never tried before.
High achievers offering words of wisdom to the upcoming class of 2022.
Relax and know that what will come and that you'll just got to try your best and it'll be all right.
Who hopefully will not have to go through online learning ever again. Patrick Murrell for 10 News First.